Hello, this is the LEGO Angry Birds Bird Island Egg Heist set. And I've got to say, right off the bat, I love the look of that structure, and especially when you look at it from a lower angle. You see, it's elevated off the ground, and there's some water around it that makes it look like a very natural setting, but I love the look of this thing. Just the shaping and the color scheme, everything just goes together really, really nicely for me. I'm sure it's a completely subjective thing, but it's actually inspiring to me. I like it so much. It makes me want to make something inspired by this that's custom for my own LEGO city. I like the interesting colors that they have for foliage, including the ones that are draped down that used to be used for seaweed and kelp pieces for underwater scenes. I like these little green recolored feather pieces that are normally originally placed in the headgear or hair pieces of minifigures, and now they're in green and they can be used as foliage and used as leaves and decorated up. And I think I speak for many, many custom builders when I say I want to have hundreds of those. They only include four in this set, and that includes the one spare one. But yeah, I like this so much, this house. It's Matilda's house here. When you look at it from the back, okay, you got a little bit of attic space up there. The tree is still there on the top, but it's just cut off completely flat. Look at that. It's so nice and round and full from the front, but then you look at it from the side and it's just cut off. It's just sliced in two. It almost feels wrong to do that. It almost feels like it would have hurt the building or something. But you know, that's what they had to do to keep the parts count down to a reasonable level to be able to match the budget for the set. And it allows you to get into the back, so you can store some stuff up on the top in the kind of attic area, and you are able to get figures in there just a little bit. There's only a little bit of space. This is where you can do some art to help with anger management issues, where Red is supposed to go to get his anger out. So you see there, it looks like he's been painting up a whole bunch of paint splotches just angrily, just throwing them at the canvas. There's another painting over there. And this thing outside, this is a sign, is used to signify the anger management class being here. And it's very bright and lively and happy looking. But the idea, I guess at some point in the movie, Red gets mad at the sign and actually starts attacking the sign. So they've got the sign on a swivel so you can hit it and make it spin around. So you can actually take out some of your anger on that as well. The biker pig in this set gets this three-wheeler setup, which I also like very, very much. It has just ridiculous proportions to it, but I really like it. I like how large that front tire is, and I like how well that LEGO has done in just capturing that look of this universe and how things would be. They've got the printed pig snout or nose, nostrils piece. It's a shield, kind of shield style on the front. That's actually, in this case, an inverted tile, 2x2 tile. And the whole thing is leaning back. It's got a couple of balloons on the back, which are removable if you want. And you also have a little basket back there so you can place some stolen eggs back there if you find them. And the set does come with a couple of little nests with two eggs each, so a total of four eggs included there. This is just good stuff. This seems like it would be fun to, you know, for kids to just roll around, because the big tire just really asks to be played with, I think. And all of the tires are far enough off the ground that you can actually take it over a little bit of carpeting and stuff. It makes for a good toy, I think. And it's pretty durable. I mean, you push down on this, you actually see it bending in the center, and that's just the plastic bending just from the stress, because, you know, the front forks stick out so far. But it actually holds itself together pretty well. This is my very first video with these new balloon pieces, the lower section, so I wanted to show those a little bit better. That's how that comes off. It's a new piece, has a anti-stud on the base and also a bar-sized hole going through it. And you can attach, well, you already saw this style of dome piece, so just to show you a different color there so it matches up how that shapes. And it's just a little bit different way of doing something like this, but it does seal up completely and it's a little bit taller. The figures here are Red Matilda and the biker Pig. Red and Matilda both have the new style of arms, which do not articulate. They're able to rotate up and down, but there is no joint inside of them, and you can't rotate the hands either. Whereas the pigs throughout this series get the regular minifig style arms, which have hands that can be rotated around. All of these look like they have pretty good personalities. I like the choices of prints here. I like the printing for the tuft on the top of Matilda. And you also saw that you get a little bit of print around the back for the pig gang sign on the, or emblem on the back of the biker pig there. No other particular coloring, but I really do like the coloring of the tufts, both the head crest and the tail feathers for Matilda. The set makes me happy. I look at it and I kind of smile inside. This is good Lego stuff. It makes for a good toy set, I think, and makes for a good Lego set. It was enjoyable to put together. Looks nice on display. Comes with a good selection of figures for the theme, I think. Nice colorfulness to the whole thing. Comes with a set of eggs. Everything that I could ask for in this set is here. I think this is really well done. Please do share what you think about the set, including if you completely disagree with me and you actually dislike this set. That's perfectly fine. Share your thoughts in a comment. Just be clean and respectful about it. I'll talk to you again very soon.